Welcome to Glam and Shine with Rashmi Bedi. Our guest today is director, creative director, writer, and producer Nivedita Basu. Welcome to the show.
Thank you for having me. I mean, what a song to open with. I actually got goosebumps, you know, itte saalo ki yaad aa gayi wapas after seeing Kyuki ka title montage. Brilliant.
I was like, kahan se shuru kiya jaye? It's a long journey aur kitne hit super hit serials diye aapne. Saas Bhi Kabhi Bahu Thi, Kahani Ghar Ghar Ki, Kusum, Kis Kis Ka Naam Le. It's a long list, and I really wanted you to be part of our show because you are such an inspiration for the aspiring youth, and they can learn so much from you. So maine socha aaj Nivedita aaj hamare show pe aa rahi hai, aaj to unse pucha jayega ki kaise shuruaat hui and how to become a successful creative director like you.
See, in television, I mean, कहाँ से शुरुआत की जाए तो आई थिंक क्यूकी इज अ गुड पॉइंट टू स्टार्ट. जबकि मैंने बालाजी ज्वाइन किया था 2000 मार्च में, एंड दैट वॉज अ टाइम व्हेन क्यूकी का एक पायलट बना था जिसका नाम एकता ने रखा था अम्बा. सो क्यूकी तो बाद में आया विद यू नो द एस्ट्रोलॉजी बिट की सब कुछ के से होने लग गया, एंड दैट्स वेयर अ के सीरीज स्टार्टेड वेयर एवरीथिंग आफ्टर दैट वॉज के. सो व्हेन आई जॉइंड एकता, उस टाइम पे आई थिंक हम लोग बना रहे थे हम पांच और कोशिश एक आशा जी टीवी पे. तो वो वाले शोज थे, और फिर उन्होंने बोला कि डेली सोप कर रहे हैं. यू नो उस टाइम पे डेली सोप का ट्रेंड नहीं हुआ था, तो उन्होंने कहा था इस शो से डेली सोप की शुरुआत होगी. सो इट वाज क्वाइट इंटरेस्टिंग, यू नो. और आप बोलते शुरू कैसे करना चाहिए, टू ग्रो टिल यर यू विल बी सरप्राइज. मैं चैनल वी में थी उसके पहले 99-2000 में, एंड आई वॉज अ फुल फ्लेज्ड डायरेक्टर प्रोड्यूसर. So when my friend, you know, who offered me to go in here, she was the girl who I used to stay with, Vandana and Anil. Her husband was directing Kahani Ghar Ghar Ki ka pilot. So she said, Jitinder ki daughter bana rahi hai, kuch jaake ek bar mil. Maine kaha, Jitinder ki daughter kaun hai, mujhe kya pata, you know. So because I was not aware too much, she wasn't very popular then. So she said, no, you go and meet serial. Maine kaha, main nahi dekhti serial. So you'll be surprised. I never grew up to think I was going to enter media. I was totally on the educational side of it, and media just happened by chance, you know, because it was like, oh, I don't want to do MBA, so chalo, let's do mass comm. And then mass comm I excelled, so I got picked up in placement, you know, by Channel V, and from there the transition to Balaji happened. So when I went to Balaji, I was told to start again from the rock bottom, you know. So I was somebody literally who was probably taking Xerox of scripts, giving it to the director, then going down to the edit, just checking if the crew has come. So I was literally doing the downward work, and I was telling Vandana, ki, I said, are you sure I'm a director and I'm doing this? So she said, dekh le for some time, you know, anyways, you don't want to do the music scene for long. एंड टिल 2 months आई डिडन्ट इवन सी एकता, एंड आई वाज लाइक वंडरिंग कि कहाँ बैठती है एकता, कौन से फ्लोर पे होती, एंड हु एम आई वर्किंग फॉर, आई डोंट इवन नो, बिकॉज आई हैड एन इमीडिएट बॉस, आई वाज रिपोर्टिंग टू हर. एंड देन वन डे आई वाज इन द एडिट एंड एकता जस्ट केम देयर टू सी समथिंग एंड आई वाज जस्ट लर्निंग, बिकॉज मेरे पास कुछ काम ही नहीं था ना, तो आई यूज्ड टू गो टू द एडिट एंड आई यूज्ड टू स्टार्ट लर्निंग, बिकॉज आई सेड लेट मी सी द स्टफ, बिकॉज इफ एनी वन नीड्स मी दे जस्ट कॉल मी एंड आई जस्ट डू द छोटा मोटा काम विच आई एम डूइंग. And I was there and she was seeing the video and my senior wasn't there. And Ekta just said, who are you? And I said, I'm Nivedita, I'm this one's associate. And then she started seeing the episode and she said, you are going to fix it and show it to me in 2 hours. And I was like, okay. I mean, I didn't say no or get scared. Why? I said, okay. And that was the day, I mean, 2 months down, I immediately became the boss of the show, you know, which was quite amazing. So that is how the journey started, and it was a show called Kabhi Sautan Kabhi Saheli. I don't know if you know of that. Channel 9 pe aata tha. In fact, it was a better rated show. Agar aap Doordarshan ke level pe dekho, it had rated more than all the GEC shows.
Yeah.
KBC aur QK ke bhi upar aata tha.
Yes.
And then of course Kasauti happened. Fir Kusum, Kutum, Kahani Ghar Ghar Ki, QK. तो फिर एक एक करके मैंने ऑलमोस्ट 90 शोज एकता के करे हैं.
ओह माय गॉड, सीरियसली अमेजिंग. ओह माय गॉड,
वी वर कॉल्ड बालाजी में ना, हमारे कंपनी को दे यूज्ड टू कॉल अ फैक्ट्री, जैसे होता है ना मास प्रोडक्शन हो रहा है, सो वी यूज्ड टू बी लाइक दैट. सो आई वाज, इफ एकता हैड 16 शोज ऑन एयर अक्रॉस यू नो डिफरेंट चैनल्स, आई वाज हैंडलिंग ऑलमोस्ट 8 and 9. तो एकता आधे देखती थी, आधे हम लोग देखते थे, एंड मल्टीपल प्रोडक्शन, ऑलमोस्ट लाइक अ टीम ऑफ 30 असिस्टेंट्स विद मी, एकता के पास 20 असिस्टेंट्स, एंड बहुत मतलब स्मूथली चल रहा था. एंड ऑफ कोर्स इट वाज अ विनिंग राइड, यू नो वी वर द न्यूमेरो ऊनो इन एवरीथिंग, व्हाटएवर वी वर मेकिंग, एकता हैड द टच ऑफ गोल्ड, सो इट वाज बिकमिंग अ हिट, टच वुड, सो गॉड हैज बीन काइंड दैट वे.
But how was your experience working with Ekta? She is, of course, a pioneer of television industry. And how was your experience working with her?
See, a lot of people, you know, the people who stay out, they always have this impression of her. But I would say, you know, having started very young, I almost went to her when I was 20.
Yeah.
And even younger. And here was a boss who was hardly like 4 or 5 years elder to me. And she was like this huge success. So that's the day when I thought that, you know, whatever happens, because see, any profession and any place you go, there will be stress. Even in a house, when you're there, your parents get stressed, they get angry, they react on you. So why wouldn't she react? Because she has so much money riding on it. But there was so much to learn from her. So I was like, I am not going to leave her, come what may. Because she was like a brainchild, you know, when she would sit on a story, I didn't know anything about fiction. It was literally like I learned my storytelling and writing from her. I used to sit and in a minute she would just crack, अच्छा नहीं ये क्योंकि मैं ये करते हैं गोमसी का ये करते हैं और अंश गुजराल ये करेगा, and I was like how is she doing it, and then we jump into another meeting and then we jump into another meeting. So I think anyone who wanted to grow and wanted to become something, the best training ground was Balaji. I mean there can't be a better boss than Ekta to teach you, because every producer is not a creator, if you know. See, a producer can source people and get, but she was somebody, she didn't need anyone. She could have ran the entire company by herself. She is so talented.
Yeah.
So that is the time when I thought that I am not going to leave her side, and for 15 years I stuck by her. So yeah.
Wow. So what are the responsibility of a creative director when a filming of a show is happening?
See, you'll be surprised. It's like television, mein a creative director is actually the maker of the show. Because what happens is, in a film, what happens, a film director, he goes and works on the scripts with the writer. He goes and meets the producer. He does everything. But when you're in a daily soap, you're producing content 6 days a week.
Yeah.
You know, so director ke paas sirf utna hi time hai that he can sit on the set and just deliver. Everything else is basically the creative director. So from the scripting, to meeting the channel every week, to casting your actors, to getting your technicians, sitting on the edit, putting the background music, making sure the episode is seamless, running the scripts by Ekta, again going back to the channel for approvals. So from start to finish, if you ask me, in television, if you're a creative director, means you're on the number one position. It is bigger than a shoot wala director.
But when you were doing these serials, did you expect that this is going to be such a huge success? Like, all super hit, like, wow.
See,
actually,
Rashke,
actually.
इनफैक्ट वी वर सो इन टू अर स्टफ यू नो आई मीन वी यूज टू यूज अर नेम्स ऑल्सो एज कैरेक्टर्स इवन क्यूकी एंड अ निवेदिता देन अ कहानी एंड अ निवेदिता देन अ कसौटी ऑफकोर्स निवेदिता वासु बिकेम वेरी famous, you know, but unfortunately they were all vamps and I used to ask Ekta, I said, Ekta, why are you saying vamps ke liye mera naam? That was just anything. We used to just sit randomly and be like, what name? Achha, Nivedita, let's use your name. And Nivedita Basu, of course, in Kasauti became iconic and you were asking me that how did it feel? You know, so the thing was, see, at that time, no, there was not so much of social media. So our only test of asking or knowing that a show was success to meet people and get, you know, feedback from them. So whenever we used to enter a building and we're going by stairs, you know, so I used to pass the stairs and I used to hear, achha, yahan pe kyun ki baj raha hai? Oh, yahan pe kusum baj raha hai. Mm-hmm. So that's my test and I would come down in a building and I would go with Ekta walking. You know, we used to go twice a week to Siddhivinayak walking, which is about 14-15 kilometers from where we used to stay. Okay. And on the road se leke mandir tak, there were people, there were even old aunties who would fall down sometime on Ekta's feet saying, aap to bhagwan hai. And Ekta used to feel so embarrassed because they were like old grandmother kind aunties. Yes. So I think that was the time when I started realizing that we were a true success, you know, it was not just an inflated success. So every common person was seeing us. Our maid would come and she would ask me, Didi, batao, abhi kya karegi Parvati? So, you know, it was really like, okay, so you're getting a right response. And that time, I think there was not so much competition also, or probably we were the only ones who were delivering a lot of stuff. So obviously it felt great, but like I said, there was no social media. So we were never affected by it. The whole idea was that, okay, one worked, second worked, third worked. We were on that whole adrenaline rush. So we always wanted to make more. We never really gloated in the success of it. Of course, when we used to go to awards, it's like in 30 nomination, 28 used to be like Balaji and Ekta. And we were like, okay, we'll take the awards and go home. So for almost 7-8 years, till Kyuki survived in 2008, it was like there was nothing which would like move us. We were like there. Of course, good stuff came in. They also made a mark simultaneously. But Ekta had a very, very successful ride. And obviously, being with her, I also enjoyed that success. But like I said, we didn't work towards, you know, ki, okay, are we getting the ratings and all? Because it was not an intention. But Ekta was very sure she wanted to make a show which was great. Yeah. And yes, she was very competitive. So I wouldn't say that if the ratings were down, she would be like, okay. She would badger us. So hum log kabhi, in fact, bank bhi nahi manate the episodes ka, you know. So literally, we used to be shooting tomorrow's episode today because, you know, if the ratings haven't come, Ekta would scrap all the episodes, even if I worked like for a week, and she would scrap them and she would rework it to make sure that we get the rating the next day. So it was a very stressful life. I mean, if somebody asked me how you grew, I said, it is a lot of hard work, you know.
Of course, yeah.
Because very less creatives are known in the industry, but Ekta made sure that she put me on a pedestal where I get known. People know me by my name. Otherwise, there are so many shows. I mean, how would you know who's the creative director of Kis Desh Mein or who was the creative director of Bhabhi Ji or, you know, of Kum Kum. So, Ekta gave me that platform and I really respect her and you know, love her for doing that. And obviously, we did enjoy the success. Who doesn't enjoy success? I mean, it gives you the motivation to do better and better.
Of course, of course. Madam, I'm like talking to you and I'm really feeling so much of like inner happiness and joy as if it is happening now. You know, I'm like,
yeah.
Because your graph is shooting up higher than higher, you know. So, you have your own production house. So I would like to know about that also.
So in 2015, you know, while I was in Balaji and that time I'd started freelancing with her, you know, so I was doing a show and she had also given me the option to do anything outside. So I had my Rocky brother, I don't know, you know, Vikas Gupta, you know, he was a mastermind in Big Boss. I don't know if you know
of
him.
Course, of course.
He is my brother. So he was working in a channel and he gave me an offer. He used to tell me 2 years back also that Didi become a producer. And he came up with this show called Meri Awaaz Hi Pehchaan Hai. You know, that was my debut show and under the production House of Originals. And I think I was so proud to do that show because that was first, you know, series kind of show on television. I had Zarina Wahab, Deepti Nawal, Amrita Rao, Aditi Vasudev. It was all a film crew which was working on it. And if you see the product, it's almost like a feature. So the girl who was writing it was Bhavani Iyer, the girl who's written Razi, Black, Guzarish. You know, so my test was that when we were doing the show for the Zee Network, you know, भवानी स्टार्टेड गेटिंग कॉल फ्रॉम सूरज बरजात्या, देन संजय लीला बंसाली इन कॉलिंग एंड टेलिंग हर दैट आई रियली लाइक योर शो मेरी आवाज. सो दैट वाज अ वेरी प्राउड मोमेंट दैट आई डेब्यूड माय सेल्फ विद अ वेरी डिफरेंट काइंड ऑफ अ शो. यू नो इट वाज द लता आशा बायोपिक. सो यू नो आफ्टर हैविंग डन द सास बहू स्टफ व्हेन आई वेंचर्ड आउट द होल आइडिया वाज टू डू समथिंग डिफरेंट बिकॉज ऑब्वियसली आई कांट डू मास प्रोडक्शन लाइक एकता. सो आई वॉन्टेड टू डू लिमिटेड स्टफ बट गुड स्टफ यू नो. सो that happened and then they were like no now you do a commercial kyunki kind of a show because you've done that all your life as a producer and do that. Then I did a show called Ek Viva Aisa Bhi again for the Z network and while I was doing that I had my baby, you know, so I was like now I'll take a break for 2 years. So yeah, so that was a conscious effort because I know in Balaji I would have never had the time to give to the baby. So I took like a nice sabbatical for 2 years. I was doing my writing work and also I was writing content for some.
I wanted to ask you on that, like you are a writer also, yaar. Koi bhi field nahi Navita jo aapne chhodi hui hai. So like what thoughts come in your mind? Kya likhna pasand karte ho aap? And what is your favorite topic? Like you like to like ye mujhe ko pasand hai, main is pe likhna chahungi. I'd like to know about that also.
See, you all know what all I've done. You know, I've done mostly Saas Bahu. So that is really easy. That, I mean, it comes naturally to me. And like I said, if I've done more than 95 daily soaps and shows, I mean, that is like at the back of my head. You know, that's not something where I have to like put my head and tail to it. But if you ask me as a passion, what I like now I'm moving on to OTT and, you know, film side. So I prefer more darker, you know, stories, which is very, you know, very unusual. People don't expect me to do that. So there's one genre which I like, which is comedy, which is the toughest to write, you know. So comedy is something which I feel, not the slapstick kind, but the real kind. So if you ask me, comedy means like say a Shubh Mangal Savdhan or say a Badhai Ho or say a Andhadun, you know, so that space. And but the more grittier stuff is what I like, you know. So I like dark crime, thriller, whodunit, murder, mystery. So that is the kind of genre which I'm exploring now in the OTT platforms because I feel that I'm very desi and to the this thing, you know. So dharti se judi hui kind of a insaan hu, whereas people used to think otherwise, you know. They used to think I'm very larger than life because I used to create, you know, bajaj 400 crore leke jeet rahe. So I said I've done that, but if you ask me from heart of heart what I want to do, these are the genres I want to explore, you know, the darker stories. Like now Netflix from India has created some really good content, you know, Jamtar aaya, fir Taj Mahal 1989 aaya, then a series called She came, and now on Amazon Prime there's something called Patal Lok, which is like bang on. That's exactly the kind of content I want to make. If you've seen Gangs of Vasaipur, you know, so that kind of dark space is what I want to explore now in the OTT platform side.
Yeah, of course, it has a brighter future, and I really wanted to ask you this thing also, like, you have been in industry for so long, so what difference you feel like? It's almost like so many years you have been there. So ab to kafi saal ho gaye, to kya farak lagta hai when you started and now, what difference you feel?
See, like I said, we were fortunate to have started back in 2000. Now the television industry has changed, you know. I mean, when we were doing our shows, it was like every show was minimum running for 3 to 4 years.
Yeah.
So the, you know, the longest run is like 8 years or 9 years or 10 years. But now when you see the shelf life of shows is very less, you know, because there's so much competition. There are like 20 channels which are making shows, you know. So agar you don't get rating even for like 1 week, the channels get uneasy and they like change the show, get somebody else. So the shelf life of shows has become very less, which is I don't think it's a great thing, because at that time, you know, people used to trust you. So a channel used to trust you that fine, if 2 weeks the ratings haven't come, we trust you because you did make a good show. Take your time and come back. But now people have lost patience. You know, they don't want to give you that kind of time. And like I said, after having done so much television content, you know, it's moving more towards like Ekta show, Nagin does very well. Supernatural does very well. Saas Bahu also, now people don't want to see just Saas Bahu. People want to see feel good stuff because they've been exposed to so much content now. You know, earlier television and viewing was very restrictive. With OTT coming in, people are seeing a lot of different content, you know, so they don't probably want to see regressive stuff. Of course, the Saas Bahu trend will always stay. If you say television, has it changed in 20 years in terms of content? I don't think so. You know, in fact, Nagin was a show which Jeetu ji had done, had done the film Nagin some 30, 40 years back.
Yeah, of course.
And it's still working today. So if you say television, see, the audience of television doesn't change. So I don't think television as such in terms of content will change. But I told you in terms of deliverance, it has changed because people don't have the patience. They want to see it. If it doesn't work, change it. If it doesn't work, change it. If it doesn't work, change it. So I feel it's a scary time for a producer to get in, you know, because when you go in with X amount of funds, you know, to make a show and a show gets pulled off halfway, you know, you haven't broken even. You cannot force the channel because the channel is like, we can't do anything. Advertiser is not putting money. So it becomes a little scary, you know. So, but web is that way is more convenient because you have a stipulated time, you have a stipulated content to put. You make it, you get your commission money, and you're out of it. So in 8 episodes or 9 episodes, you're able to deliver what you want, and it's a win-win for everyone. So you know from the beginning it's 9. But in a daily soap, you sign for a year's contract. In 2 months, the show doesn't do well, the 3rd month it's out. So you haven't even broken even your money, you know, like that. So even for people who are venturing out in television, I mean, it's a, I'm just trying to like give you an insight into it, that think twice before getting into it. And people are getting into it, you know, with one or two shows, you won't become a millionaire, like some people say, unless you really strike gold with one show, you know, like one show which is running for 10 years. But unfortunately, that is not the future now. People are very, they're very fickle-minded. Their attention span is very little. If they don't like it, remote change, remote change.
Absolutely right. So what difference you feel in the artist also? You have been working with so many. What do you difference you feel tab aur aapke artist mein? Do you feel any difference or it's just the same thing you feel?
Of course, there is a huge difference, Rashmi. I mean, I am fortunate that, you know, we came at the time of Smriti Irani and Sakshi Tanwar and Prerna and all the ensemble cast. I mean, if Kyunki had 32 main characters, all 32 were handpicked, you know, at a point where there was no social media, you know, to compete with. They knew that if they perform on the floor, if they know their craft is only when they will get popular and more scenes. So it was a very clear demarcation that all you had to do was perform and make good content and deliver. Whereas now what has happened is that, you know, with social media, with you know, Instagram, Facebook, TikTok, so people are more popular there on that medium, you know. So the craft has kind of fizzled out, which is very unfortunate. You know, now when I see the actors, so if that time I was working with, say, 100 actors on 5 shows, I knew 85 were class acts. You know, maybe 15 were kam zyada because some we took in terms of looks of a character, some we took in terms of, you know, something which we wanted in the show. But 85 characters out of 100 would be proper. But if you say now in terms of, if I say 100, if I get 15 also out of 100, I think I will be like blessed. So that is how bad the comparison is.
Gosh.
Maybe there are good people also in the medium, but like I said, that is the whole this thing, you know. So people say we've done very good TikToks, we're very popular on Facebook and Instagram, but unfortunately, you know, that is not what takes you further. What takes you further is you know, how you are on your craft, and that is where I think people have stopped delivering because they feel, oh, I'll be popular on Instagram and TikTok and that'll work. So I mean, that is something which youngsters need to really work on.
So who had been your favorite actor and actresses? You have worked with so many. It's a tough, difficult
But like
question.
I
I know.
said, see, I was fortunate enough to work with a lot of them. I mean, Smriti Irani, if you know her, there would be nobody who would not find her, you know, like perfect. Then Sakshi was there. Ronit Roy has always been like my favorite, you know. I mean, we took him in Kasauti, and then there was Mihir who was not there, and then Ekta said shift in there. I was like, wow, both my shows, Ronit is there, you know, so it's quite a.
Of
So
course, of course.
it was like, it was a fight between me also. Then there was Kasam Se Bita, where I used to like Bani, I used to like Ram Kapoor. So
Yeah,
I think,
Kapoor is amazing.
you know, like, 20 years down now also when I meet the actors, because they left such an impact, and you know, in the script also we used to really use them like very intelligently. So most of them left an impact. But like I said, a few of our favorites, if you ask me, are Kyuki, Kahani, Kasauti, Kutum, Hiten and Gauri in Kutum were there, and then they were also in Kyuki, you know, as Karan and this one, what is it, Nandini. So everyone had left a different impact on me, and I'm quite happy that I worked at that time, you know, where these kind of actors are created, because they are still there. I mean, of course, Smriti has reached the cabinet and she's a part of the government, but the actors I worked with back then in 20 years are still there now. But the actors who started 5 years back, unfortunately, are not there today. You know, so you can see how the system has gone. Whereas in the films, it's working the other way, you know. Films, the names are not really that matter. It's the craft, you know, like an Ayushman came, a Rajkumar Rao came, विकी कौशल हैज कम इन, सो तापसी पन्नू, दे आर नॉट, देर इज नो नेपोटिज्म देयर, दे ओनली कम इन फॉर देयर क्राफ्ट एंड देयर वर्क. सो आई थिंक I mean, films have graduated to become more of the craft, and unfortunately, television, because the television stars are getting instant fame, you know, because of social media, being popular, having 10 million followers on TikTok, 20 million on Instagram. So that is kind of, I think, making their vision a little hazy and taking them away from their craft. And I think if they can go back to that, you know, today when I meet actors, it's very unfortunate, you know, that they'll only talk about their social media presence. So they will say, oh, I'm trying to work on my size zero. Oh, I have to go to the gym. I have to do this. But nobody really says that I want to take this class of this theater. Okay, this film has really worked or this thing. Who do you think is the best teacher for it? You know, whereas when earlier we were working with actors, they would come and ask us that what you didn't like in this scene. Okay, you didn't like, give me a reference of another film which you like. So, like I said, because people were probably insecure at that time more, you know, they were like, if we don't perform, we will not get screen presence. Imagine in a family of 32 of Kyunki, everyone needs to get some space. So, they only get it if they perform. If you don't perform, I have 31 other actors to put on. If you don't perform, I have 30 more. If you don't perform, I have 29 more. So, there was always a second best, you know, who was there. So, that is the difference now which has come probably, I feel, in television.
That's absolutely right, and what you are saying, I totally agree with that. I would like you to share experience. You are team owner of Box Cricket League, right? So I would like you to share that too.
So Box Cricket League actually happened at my studio where I'm sitting right now. You know, my friends came up and they said, we want to create an IP, you know, which is, so there were these two guys who came and they said, Navi, what should we do? Let's get girls on board. So that's how we bounced. And, you know, they said, if girls are playing, they don't want to tan, you know, if the heroines are playing, they don't want to get tanned in the sun and get hurt by, you know, those seasoned balls. So that's when the concept of a softy ball, a squeezy ball came in. So the whole concept was kind of made here. And I remember the first season, which we call the ground season, was made like, he said that, Nivedita, you work with so many television stars. Let's get television stars to come on board because they are stars, you know, if they are Tulsi there or if they are Parvati, let's see them on the field when they are, you know, in a totally different attire. So they would peg it on the field like, ki, acha, today a Saas is going to be facing the Bahu's ball. You know, so they made it dramatic and interesting, the Box Cricket League. And then, of course, Ekta bought it in 2016 and 17. So it became obviously more bigger because it went on to Colors and Sony. So it was quite an interesting thing because, one, you feel almost like not probably as big as IPL, but you're almost like an owner of a team, you know, Kolkata Babu Mosha is. And you're almost working with 25 actors on a day-to-day basis who are actually quite, they were quite happy with the game, you know, because one, it was an indoor game. There was AC. Mm-hmm. So, obviously, the seasoned cricketers would feel, ki, yaar, kya softy ball se khila rahe ho, ladkiyo ki tarah. You know, but eventually, they got used to it. And the whole idea was that, I think the first season, which was televised, it was almost like a big boss, you know, because everyone was pitched against each other. The girlfriend was in one team, the boyfriend was in another team, wow, husband is in one, the wife is in one. So it was quite interesting masala, very different masala in a sports property.
Awesome. What are your upcoming projects, Nivedita?
So unfortunately, you know, we are in trying times right now because of COVID-19. But, you know, what has happened is that because of the corona, everyone's stationed at home and watching a lot of content, you know. So fortunately or unfortunately, we are in a good phase where people want to see more content. In fact, one show gets over, they are always pushing the OTT platform that what is coming next. Yeah. So during these time, you know, I was going actually on floor with two of my series, which I was directing. So I have now turned a director. I'm going to go back to direction, which I did in 99. And I've trained to be a director. I've started to be a filmmaker. So now I'm going back to being a director more than a producer because I feel that is where my thing is. You know, I eventually want to direct films. So I'm now directing a web series. But unfortunately, because of the lockdown, we're all stationed at home. So I'm scripting now to other things, you know, which have been pitched and approved. So like I said, because I've been wearing a lot of hats, you know, so if not direction, I'm writing now. And then, of course, we are watching a lot of content ourselves because there is a lot of good content, you know, which in our day-to-day life, we don't get to watch. You know, I mean, we're only in Bombay, especially being in Bombay, we're only running from one place to the other. And most of the time is wasted on the roads, if you're aware of it. You know, Bombay is like a mess when it comes to traveling.
Okay.
So I think the lockdown has worked good in a way that one, the nature has kind of slowed down, you know, things are more peaceful. I mean, that whole rat race, which the whole country is in, Bombay especially, has kind of slowed down. And it's giving me good time to write freely, you know. I mean, whenever you're usually writing or, you know, you're always delivering on a timeline. So sometimes maybe you compromise. You never know, you know, if you're working on a very time-bound thing, you may be compromising. But now, because there is no time-bound thing, you're writing freely, you're thinking freely, because you're watching numerous amount of content. I'm watching Iranian content, then I'm watching Spanish content, then I'm watching Icelandic content. So you're kind of seeing what is happening across the world. And now being on web, what happens is whatever you create is for the world to see. It's not like only my locality auntie is going to watch what I'm making.
Yeah.
It's going to be across, you know, the world for them to watch.
Yeah, it was so nice. Yeah, it's really great actually talking to you. I mean, I really don't want to end the show today because so much to learn from you. And I'm like,
I'm so glad, Rashmi. I mean,
it's actually a very informative session, you know, and it's very inspiring. And you are such a wonderful person.
Oh, but you're quite a complete host, Rashmi. I should congratulate you. I know Shikha Sharma, you know, my friend who had told me about you. And then, of course, Gaurav Tiwari, thanks to him, he kind of streamlined the whole thing to happen. But she was raving about you. She kept saying, Nivedita, you were like, I said, let me meet. And today I can see how dynamic you are and how you have a very successful show and a beautiful pageant. So I know out there in America also, people are very, you know, they are always very aspiring towards the, you know, the Bombay and the Bollywood life. And like I said, it doesn't come easy. Of course, it's a lot to do with destiny and timing also, you know, because obviously millions of people come here. They say, how come only 50 strike? So one, I would say that, see, a lot of people say it's also to do with connections. See, with connections, you can only go one fold. But if you don't deliver after that, a connection cannot work. You know, I mean, unless you're really numero position, you know, or you're a superstar's child, you might get 10 chances. But after that, also the audience will reject you. So you have to keep working on your craft constantly and wait for the right time. I mean, that it's all a game of patience, Rashmi. I mean, you cannot run away from hard work is what I would say. You know, I mean, if people think that there is some shortcut to success, it's not. You know, you see an actor doing very fancy thing, getting awards, but you don't see the hard work going into it. You know, today if a Tapsi is doing a thappad, she might have to do the same thappad scene like 50 times to get the right take. You know, they might have to work on a night outdoor. They might have to work day night sitting in keechad because the scene requires that, you know, she's getting stuck in a keechad for those. So there's a lot of hard work which goes in. So I always had a lot of respect for my TV actors who worked back then because we used to not send them home. I mean, Rashmi, that's a trivia I'll give you. We used to have people sleep on our sets because, like I said, we were shooting today for tomorrow. So it was like the actors had their brushes, kids, everyone there. So it was like, acha, abhi Tulsi ka scene ho raha hai, acha, peeche se tum aa jao, abhi tumhara scene hai. Hiten, phir peeche se adi Akashdeep, tum aa jao, tumhara scene hai. So they were literally brushing, washing their face and going into, you know, the set to do their scene. In fact, in Balaji building, we had made bunker beds. So we too used to not go home only. So everyone used to go take a 1 hour nap, then come out. Then take a 2 hour nap, then again come out. So it was quite exciting, like I said. So you asked me, you know, if I enjoyed it, if I knew the whole extent of success. Yeah. We knew the extent of passion we all had, you know. So it was not like just Ekta was working 24 hours. Ekta ke niche I was working. Mere niche sab actors were working. So it was never like, why is she getting the success?
It's because, a teamwork.
Yeah, so it was always a teamwork and everyone gave like their full 100%. And that is why I think the success was there.
Yeah, you have to think that it's not only me, it's we. When it's a thing like a we, it makes a lot of impact and a lot of sense. And results are great.
And yes.
It's so nice, like so much to learn from you. Now, my person sachi mein Nivedita, tumhari tareef ke liye shabd hi kam pad gaye. Like, I am your big fan.
Thank you so much for having me. It was a pleasure always. I mean, it's so nice to, you know, like have somebody question you because we always take these things for granted, but we don't realize that the other people want to know, you know, how the journey was. Was it easy that I just stepped in and it happened? So it's always nice to share your experiences because we are all about experience.
Yes, glam and shine hai isi liye, taki behind the scene, what a hard work or everybody, like
Wishing you
Derek
the very
Chung.
best. I was just seeing the montage of the kind of people you interviewed. I think you had all veterans on your show. You're doing a commendable job, you and
I want to
Janakji.
bring everyone behind the scene people on screen so that the world should know about them and that so much of hard work and effort is there and see the results are great. And we are looking forward for your super hit movie, upcoming movie, I should say, you know. You have given so many super hit serials.
Thank you
We are
so
so
much.
proud of you, Nivedita. It was great talking to you dear on the show and seriously,
Thank you.
Abhibi, I'm feeling such a great joy and thank you so much. Thanks a ton.
Thank you. Wishing you all the best, you
Thank
and your
you.
team. Thank you. Take care.
मैं हूँ रश्मि बेदी. हमें उम्मीद है ये शो आपको पसंद आया होगा. लेटेस्ट वीडियो के लिए देखते रहिए माय ड्रीम टीवी यूएसए और पसंद आने पर लाइक, शेयर और सब्सक्राइब करना ना भूलें. थैंक्स फॉर वॉचिंग माय ड्रीम टीवी यूएसए.